This is what you do on your very first day in Paris. You get yourself some rain. Not just a drizzle, but honest-to-goodness rain. Then you find yourself someone really nice and drive her through the Bois de Boulogne in a taxi. The rain's very important because that's when Paris smells its sweetest. It's the damp chestnut trees, you see?
I see.
You're very clever, Linus, and very rich. You can order yourself some rain.
Oh, sure. I can order myself some rain. I can get myself a taxi. That's easy. But can I find myself someone really nice? That's not so easy, Sabrina. Say in French, my sister has a yellow pencil.
Ma soeur a un crayon jaune.
How do you say, my brother has a lovely girl?
Mon frère a une gentille petite amie.
And how do you say, I wish I were my brother?
Ça me fait quelque chose. Il est entré dans mon cœur une part de bonheur.
Why are you looking at me that way?
All night long I've had the most terrible impulse to do something.
Oh, never resist an impulse, Sabrina. Especially if it's terrible.
I'm going to do it. There.
What's that for?
We can't have you walking up and down the Champs-Élysées looking like a tourist undertaker. And another thing, never a briefcase in Paris and never an umbrella. There's a law.
How am I ever going to get along in Paris without someone like you? Who'll be there to help me with my French? To turn down the brim of my hat?
Suppose you meet someone on the boat the very first day out. A perfect stranger.
I have a better suppose, Sabrina. Suppose I were 10 years younger. Suppose you weren't in love with David. Suppose I asked you to. I suppose I'm just talking nonsense.
I suppose so.
Suppose you sing that song again. Slowly.
Il me prend dans ses bras et me parle tout bas. Je vois la vie en rose. Il me dit des mots d'amour.
Who is Sabrina?
Our chauffeur's daughter. That's who she is. Now, how about that gentleman? Linus Larrabee, wizard of finance, man of distinction, chairman of the board of Larrabee Industries, getting mixed up with his chauffeur's daughter.
That's enough, David.
She went after me for a while, but then she switched to Linus. I guess it's because he's got more money. Now, we all know about those kind of girls, and believe me, gentlemen, this one is no different. Just seems to be.
I said that's enough.
Maybe you got smart, Linus. Or maybe you just got lucky, because you're here, and she's out there. Brother, she would have taken you for plenty. I was just helping you make up your mind. You are in love with her. Well, what are you waiting for?
There's an elevator outside, a police escort downstairs, and a tugboat standing by at the Larrabee Pier.
Get moving!
Well, if you'll excuse me, gentlemen, it appears I have a previous engagement.
That's the 20th century for you. Automobiles, garages, chauffeurs, chauffeurs' daughters. Inasmuch as I seem to be the only member of the Larrabee family who is not completely out of his mind, I will take it upon myself to call this meeting back to order as soon as David Larrabee removes his carcass from this table.
Sit down, Father.
The olives.
Fairchild, il y a un monsieur sur le bateau qui voudrait bien que vous lui arrangiez son chapeau.
Voilà.
Merci beaucoup. Thank you.